new ultrapotent COVID-19 vaccine could produce extremely high antibody levels. Nanotechnology is becoming a trend in experimental COVID-19 drugs. One example is the ongoing experimental vaccine by scientists at the University of Washington School of Medicine. Their design elicited potent neutralizing antibodies in mice models. The potency was found better than antibodies in people who survived COVID-19. UW Assistant Professor Neil King said, "We hope that our nanoparticle platform may help fight this pandemic that is causing so much damage to our world." In the paper published in the Cell Journal, the experimental vaccine features a two-part nanoparticle platform. Scientists created the vaccine using a structure-based design. It involves a self-assembling protein nanoparticle that can display the receptor binding domain or RBD of the coronavirus. It can display up to 60 copies of this RBD, roughly imitating the virus itself. This imitation allows the immune system to better detect the RBD, which it needs to produce neutralizing antibodies. Leveraging RBD has importance because the immune system tends to react to it better, compared to the spike protein only. Presently, the experimental vaccine is in preclinical testing. Mice models were vaccinated and analyzed for antibody activity. Early findings suggested up to 10 times better neutralizing antibodies compared to antibodies in COVID-19 human survivors. B cell activity was also detected in the analysis. The B cell response was determined strong and might play a part in immune memory and persistent vaccine effect. Scientists vaccinated a single non-human primate as well. The experimental vaccine produced neutralizing antibodies that targeted various sites of the spike protein. One of the implications of the findings is the potential to combat mutations. Since it targets multiple sites of the spike protein, the vaccine may overcome currently known mutations. The ultrapotent nanoparticle vaccine is safe and effective at low doses in animal models. Manufacturers may produce it using simple instruments and do not require to have it stored in a freezer. The convenience in manufacturing and storage may enable its global distribution in the future. The biotech company IcoSavax already acquired a license to advance the experimental vaccine. Studies are now in progress to support regulatory filings. Another biotech company, Amgen, is working with IcoSavax to accelerate the vaccine's progress to early-stage clinical trials. SK Bioscience in South Korea is also conducting its own studies of the vaccine.